Thank you. Bhagavad Gita, Lord Krishna describes the process of devotional
service.
Lord Krishna is saying, the thoughts of my pure devotees dwell in me. Their lives are surrendered unto me, and they derive great satisfaction and bliss, enlightening one another and conversing about
it.
So as Lalita Mataji said, the devotees come together, it's an opportunity to share, to inquire and to respond and try to give answers. All of the scriptures are based on questions and answers. Sukadeva Goswami answered the questions of Maharaj Parikshit.
Sukadeva Goswami 回答了这个巴利杰国王的问题.
Maharaj Parikshit had only 7 days to live, so he was anxious to know how he should prepare for death.
巴利杰国王只剩下7天的日子, 所以他在询问说他要怎么来准备这个死亡。
And the result of his question was the speaking of the Srimad Bhagavatam.
那个结果就是他询问的结果就是产生出这个国家瓦坛。
Maybe you've read some of the Srimad Bhagavatam.
可能是有一些人来又读到了国家瓦坛。
你们开始读国家网？有，第二，我们在群上面有一个群众们在读经典，每天都在读什么？每天读，哦，那么好。对，今天刚好轮到我读。哦，是啊，今天刚好轮到我。关，我们有一个领读，然后就大家跟读这样子，每天读经典。有多少人参加？有60几个人。
都是台湾的。台湾的。都是台湾的。都是台湾的。很好。Yeah, in China we have many also like that groups reading scripture. 在中国大陆也是有很多的这个经典的这个小组。But it's good to read the books, but it's more important to discuss them together. 去读是很重要，很好。那去讨论是更加的重要。 Sometimes people just read and they ask, what did you read? They don't know anything, they didn't understand anything.
有时候人们读了，然后你问他读了什么，他们其实并不了解。
So Prabhupada said, more important than reading is to explain and to discuss together.
所以他们还说，比阅读更重要，就是一起来讨论。
To explain.
去解释，然后去讨论。
And so, Bhagavad Gita describes the process of devotional service by coming together and sharing our doubts and our problems which we may have in devotional service, and hearing how we can
状况。
所以呢，方法说到这个程序，就是说我们大家聚在一起，然后来讨论叙述讨论一起，然后再聆听看提出来要解决呀、啊，有什么要需要解决这些来讨论。
We see a nice example of question and answers was when Lord Chaitanya met with a devotee named Ramananda Das.
关于提问跟回答一个很好的例子，就是说，就 Chaitanya 他遇到一个奉献者叫做 Ramananda Roy.
So Ramananda Rai was a householder, and he was born in what is considered not the most.Not a very high position in society. He was born in other words, a low-class family.
Ramananda Roy 呢，他出生的家庭被认为他是居士，而且他出生他的家庭背景被认为不是说很高阶的这种家庭。
And Lord Chaitanya Mahaprabhu was born in a Brahmana family, and he went on to become also a sannyasi in the renounced order of life.
那主持人妈法布出生在婆罗门家庭，然后来他接受了这个弃绝，就是我们一般说出家这样子的生活。
And remember also, Chaitanya Mahaprabhu is incarnation of Krishna, and he is considered the most merciful of all Krishna's incarnations.
我们记得主持人妈法布就是 Krishna 本人，那。
So the two of them met together, and Ramananda Rai was actually working in the service of the king of Jagannath Puri.
那 Ramananda Rai 呢，他就是有在从事做任职工作，他是在这个 Jagannath Puri 那边的国王那儿做事。
And he was.Engaged in the service of governing a region in the south of the kingdom of that king.
他的职位是管理在那个布里国王的地区的南方的那一些事务。
You've been to India, right? Did you go to Chennai?
No.
为什么去Chennai
呢？没有
印度吗？
So he was governor in a region around there in South India.
他先前是在那个南印度那边的一个首长，类似一个省长这样子。
So when the two met together, Lord Chaitanya began to put questions to Ramananda Roy.
当他们两个相见的时候呢，主切泰玛普布就对这个 Ramananda Roy 来问一些问题。
And Ramananda Rai thought this is not very proper because, you know, I'm in the householder family life, I'm in the material life, and I'm not born in a very good family, so it's not really proper for me to be answering your questions.
但是 Ramananda Rai 他就觉得他这样是不恰当的，因为他认为他不是出生很好背景，也不是出生在婆罗门家庭，要他来回答问题似乎是不恰当的。
But Lord Chaitanya responded to Ramananda Rai. He said, "Well, no, you're qualified because you know the talk, you know the science, you know the teachings of Lord Krishna."
但是，就切干妈宝姑就说呢。但是你是有资格，因为你是了解了这个这门科学，奉爱的科学。
So because Ramananda Rai was acquainted with the teachings of Lord Krishna, he could give the proper answers to all the questions of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu.
因为
he was acquainted with the teachings of Lord Krishna.
那个 Ramananda Roy 对于这个主 Krishna 的教导非常的熟悉，所以呢，他可以很好恰当的回答出主 Chaitanya Mahaprabhu 的问题。
So this is the principle behind Krishna consciousness, that anyone in any position in life, if they are knowing the teachings of Krishna, then they can accept the position of being a spiritual teacher.
所以这是 Krishna 知觉的原则。不管一个人是在什么样的生活阶段、什么样的背景，只要他对这个这门知识是熟悉，这门科学熟悉的话，很了解，他自然是可以做一个灵性的这个老师。
Srila Prabhupada was a teacher. He was not born in a Brahmana family.
Prabhupada 也是一个老师，但他不是出生在婆罗门家庭。
And he did spend many years in family life, and he worked also as he had a business.
而且他花很多年时间在这个居室生活，然后他也去就是为了生活去做生意。
But he did have the good fortune of being born in a family of devotees.
而他没有那么幸运，说出生在奉献者的家庭里。
他很幸运。
他很幸运的出生。对，我就想奇怪。
So from the beginning of his life, he was learning about Krishna and devotion to him.
所以他生命的初期就开始了学习对于 Krishna 的奉爱。
So Srila Prabhupada brought the teachings of Krishna consciousness to the Western world.
So Prabhupada 把 Krishna 的这个教导呢传扬到西方国家去。
And he had to meet many questions. He had to answer many questions. Many people were always questioning.
所以他经历了很多人的询问，所以他就要必须，他就自然需要回答很多的问题。
As a devotee of Krishna, we often find people come to us and ask questions about Krishna.
那身为 Krishna 的奉献者，我们也会经常经验到人们来跟我们询问。
Sometimes they ask us, "What's that mark on your face?" You know, "What's that mark on your face?"
有些时候人们问你说，你们额头上涂了什么东西，什么一团土。
What's that funny haircut? Why you've got that?Tail on the back of your head.
你们这些男生奇怪，头发后面怎么这么抓了一把？
And then they want to know about what the beads around your neck.
那你脖子上挂了那什么珠子？
Why are you dressed in these funny clothes?
或者说你们怎么穿了这些很好笑的衣服？
There's always many questions. People ask questions.
所以总是会有这个很多的问题这样问出来。
So that is actually good. That curiosity is actually a sign of the beginning of an interest in self-realization.
实际上这样是好的，因为好奇也是好的，因为这样他们就可以有对自我觉悟的一个开始。
We should be curious about spiritual identity and our golden life, a higher golden life.
所以我们对于我们的灵性的身份应该去好奇，而且对于我们这种人类这样黄金一样的机会，这样的生命的目的呢，也应该要去追寻，应该有好奇。
And we should be looking for answers to these questions.
所以我们就要去问这些问题。而且去寻求这一些问题的答案。
I was just explaining last night to a group of people. I was explaining to them how I was brought up in a Christian background. I was born in the UK, so I had a Christian upbringing.
昨天晚上我跟一群人说了，那谈到就是说我的出生是在一个基督教的背景。而且我是在英国那边所以英国出生的。
So, people would wonder why you take up this path that seems to be something like Hindu or something culture.
那人们就觉得奇怪，为什么他是这样西方的基督教背景，怎么会去接受这走上这条法门？因为这好像是说印度的啦，东方的。
So I told them, well, I'm not a Hindu.
我就跟他们说，我不是个印度教徒。
there were some Hindus there, there were some Indian students there, and they're Hindu. But I'm not a Hindu.
那边有一些学生，他们是印度教徒哈，他们印度人也是印度教徒，可是我不是那样的印度教徒。
But I do practice the principles of Bhakti Yoga.
我是在实践，我在练习这个奉爱瑜伽这些程序。
And I explained to them that the reason why I took up this Bhakti Yoga is because I got the answers to my questions.
而且我跟他们说，我会接受这个奉爱瑜伽的程序，是因为我在这里面得到所有问题的答案。
But I was questioning many things in my life and in the society and in the world, and I couldn't get very good answers.
那我也是在生活中啊，对生活啦，对社会啊，对国家，对世界的状况啊，有很多的问题在想着，可是我都没有得到很好的回答。
But when I met the devotees practicing Krishna consciousness who were doing the Bhakti Yoga, I found their answers to be the most complete and the most satisfying.
当我遇到的奉爱瑜伽的奉献者们呢，我得到的答案是最完整，而且是最让人觉得满意的。
Of course, I read some books, and I was also impressed with the content of the books. I thought the books were very well written, and that they were not difficult to understand.
当然，我也读了奉爱瑜伽里面的这一些书籍，而且我觉得这些书写得非常好，而且呢也并不难懂。
Some other books which I've been reading, I didn't know what they were talking about. Somehow the people write books, but often they're not understandable by ordinary people.
那我也读了外面一些其他的书籍，可是我觉得不知道他们在写什么。有一些人他们很疯狂的写作，可是呢，一般人根本也不知道他们写什么，不了解。
But I found the books of Srila Prabhupada to be very readable and very rich in knowledge and wisdom.
而我发现呢，泡发的书是非常很高的可读性，而且呢，里面的知识非常的丰富啊，非常的足啊。
So in this way, I was and all my questions were answered, and I was encouraged to also take up not just only my questions answered, but also apply the knowledge which I was being given.
所以呢，我就被这书这个里面的知识这个经典所吸引，而且那一些都回答我所有的疑问。那我就不只是这样读的这些书，我也实践了这书里面所说的。
So that, in the Bhagavad Gita, Lord Krishna describes how there are four kinds of people who never surrender to Krishna.
国家梵歌里面描述的就是说，有四种人，他们不向 Krishna 来臣服，不投靠。
But then he goes on to describe four kinds of people who do surrender.
然后 Krishna 接着又说到，就是有哪四种人会投靠 Krishna。
And he said of the four kinds of people who come to surrender to him, the best one is the one who's coming in search of knowledge.
那么 Krishna 说，在这四种来追寻他的人最好的那一类，就是说怀着要追求知识这样子的人。
But then Krishna goes on to say that by the path of knowledge, you make advancement very slowly. You don't progress very quickly.
然而 Krishna 也说，如果只是依靠知识这个途径来做进步的话，是非常慢的。
Lord Krishna said, you still take birth many times before you actually get the goal of the knowledge.
Krishna 实际上说，你必须要再投生很多世，才能真正到达这个知识的这个目的。
The goal of knowledge is to surrender to Krishna.
知识的目的就是来臣服 Krishna。
And Lord Krishna also giving the same conclusion of the Bhagavad Gita.But at the end of the Bhagavad Gita, he tells Arjuna that he should surrender.
Krishna 也告诉了 Arjuna， 就是告诉我们知识的终极，知识的最后，就是来向 Krishna 臣服投靠。
And so Srila Prabhupada then in this purport, he explains what it means to surrender.
对。圣帕布帕在里面的要旨有说到什么叫做臣服投靠。
That we should accept what is favorable for devotional service. And we should reject what is not favorable.
所以我们就必须接受这些合宜顺意于这个奉爱服务的，那拒绝那些不合宜不顺意于奉爱服务的。
So reading these things, I thought this is very practical knowledge. I wanted to apply this process.
所以当我在读这些书的时候，我觉得这是非常实际的知识，所以我想去把它实践应用出来。
Problem is when you start trying to apply these principles of Krishna consciousness in daily life, that people will oppose you.
问题是说。当你开始来实践练习 Krishna 知觉的这些知识里面的程序人们会有反对的。
People will say, oh, you don't have to do all that. You don't have to bother. Don't take it so seriously.
人们就是说，哎呀，你不要去烦啦，不要去管他啦，也不要把他看得太认真啦。
Just like.You want to be a vegetarian, you can get a lot of opposition.
就好像人们如果要开始去吃素食的话，也会有面临很多人的反对。
People say, oh, you want to be healthy? No, you have to eat meat. 人
们说，哎呀，你会不健康啦，你必须吃肉啦，什么的啦。
You don't, oh, no, you don't have to do all that. You said, you can eat everything.
所以那些人说，哎，你不用这样吃素那么辛苦了，你什么都可以去吃啊。
People become worried when they see someone else do something different from what they're doing, from the standards they accept. You have a different standards, and so they become worried, they become threatened. But maybe they try to make me a vegetarian.
人们会害怕，就是说，对于如果有人的行为跟我们一般所谓社会上的标准或看法不一样的时候，就会担心，很怕说啊，那个人吃素，然后也要来告诉我要吃素那种的。
So you get some teachers who compromise on these things, and they don't stress it very much.No, it's okay.
所以你们也会在外面遇到有一些所谓教什么的老师，就不会去强调素食这件事，甚至就说，哎呀，这个不要担心这件事。
There was this one teacher, Indian guru. He went to the Philippines, and he was teaching there to some Indian businessmen.
有一个印度的咕噜，他去到菲律宾，然后去菲律宾教一些所谓商人哈。
So these Indian businessmen, they were all meat eaters. You know, none of them were vegetarian.
那一些印度不在菲律宾的这些印度商人呢，他们都吃肉，不是素食的。
Do you know how to recognize a meat eater?
你怎么去分辨一个肉食者？
Meat eaters will use two hands.
哇，吃肉者用两只手来吃东西。
Yeah. you can watch some. You'll see. Well, if someone's using two hands, you know they're not a vegetarian.
所以如果你看他那个特别明显两只手在吃的， 他们不是素食的人。
You use the right hand to eat. In India, it's the culture that you use the right hand to eat, and the left hand is to clean the body.
在印度的文化呢，我们吃东西是用左手来拿来吃的。
右手
啊，不，我拿脑筋穿，我听到后面，然后脑筋就右手，然后左手做我们清洁的事。
Anyway, this Indian guru came to Philippines, and he told this Indian man, they said, but Swamiji, you know, we're not vegetarian.
但是那些人，在印度的那些商人就对这个印度来的guru说， Swamiji, 可是我们不是吃素的。
So the Swami was worried that if he told them they have to be vegetarian, they would all go away. They would not.
那个 Swami 就担心，如果叫他们吃素的话，他们那些人都跑掉了。
So he said to them, "Oh, don't worry. You don't have to leave meat. The meat will leave you. You just follow me, and the meat will leave you."
Leave, L-E-A-V-E. 然后那个 Swami 就跟他们说，你们不要担心。你们不用去放掉肉，这个肉会放掉你们，你们只要跟着我就好了。
So 30 years later, they're still eating.
但三十年之后，那一些生意人还是在吃肉。
Did the meat leave you?
他说，
Has the meat left you yet?
那些肉有没有离开你啊？
No, you're still enjoying the meat.
不啊。
So, some things are necessary to surrender to Krishna.
所以有一些事物是必要来向 Krishna 臣服的。
Sometimes in the beginning, people have bad habits.
在开始的时候，人们还有一些旧的坏习惯。
We start listening to.The Lord talks about Krishna consciousness, and you may think, well, you know, I still have bad habits. I haven't given up all my bad habits.
就是一个人开始来啊听啊，或者说到 Krishna 知觉的时候，那个人可能说啊，可是我还有一些以前的坏习惯还没改掉。
You know, like smoking cigarettes sometimes difficult for people to give up smoking cigarettes.
就像抽烟啊，对人来戒烟是很难的。
And sometimes a cup of coffee is also hard to give up.
甚至有时候连一放弃喝咖啡也很难。
Some people, sometimes, you know, some nice devotees, they said, they told me, I can't get up in the morning without a cup of tea.
有一些好奉献的跟我说，早上呢，我如果不喝一杯茶，我好像起不来。
So these are bad habits, but they can also go in course of time.
当然了，这一些是坏习惯，但是到了一个时候，这些习惯会去掉，会走掉。
Provided you follow the process.
这个条件就是要跟随这个供养里面的程序。
Process chanting Hare Krishna.
这程序就是念诵 Hare Krishna.
Read the books about Krishna.
来研读关于 Krishna 的书。
And worship Krishna.
再来崇拜 Krishna.
These three activities, they help us to get rid of all of our bad.
所以这三项活动会帮助我们来去掉那些坏习惯。
If you make it a habit to chant, to read the books, to worship Krishna, then all the bad habits, you just forget about them.
所以呢，你来练习有这个习惯来念诵 Krishna 圣名，崇拜 Krishna， 研读 Krishna 的这方面的书，那些你根本就不会去沾到，不会去想到那些坏习惯。
Krishna consciousness is not very difficult. It becomes easy.
那这样子呢，克夏是觉得生活并不困难，而且变得容易。
So we encourage all of you, you know, chant Hare Krishna, read the books, worship Krishna.
所以我鼓励你们大家也是来念诵 Hare Krishna 啊，读了这些书，然后崇拜 Krishna。
Krishna consciousness has come to you. It's come to Taichung. It's your good fortune to contact the devotees.
Krishna 知觉的幸运来到你们这里，来到台中，所以你们都有很大的幸运。
After, we have to understand we are all eternal souls. So we've been in this world a very, very long time.
我们都必须要了解，我们都是永恒的灵魂。我们啊，来到这个世界已经很久了。
We've had many births, many lives, different bodies, different places.
我们有过很多世了，出生很多世，然后有很多次的不同的身体，这样子。
Do you remember any of your births?
你记得你的某一世是怎么样吗
？No, I don't either.
我也不记得。
And Lord Krishna said, he said to Arjuna that you don't remember your previous births. He said, I remember.
这 Krishna 就是说你不记得你的过去世，可是我记得。
Krishna remembers. Krishna, that's the difference. Krishna is the supreme. He's the supreme God. He remembers. We don't.
Krishna 是至尊主，他记得一切，但我们不记得。
We don't need to remember, but we can understand that it's a fact that we have had many births in many different conditions, different positions of life.
我们不见得要去记得过去式，但是我们可以了解我们曾经有过很多次的过去式的投生。
I mean, the Vedic knowledge tells us life is not limited to just this planet. There's life all over the creation, all over the universe.
伟达知识啊，告诉我们，就是说，生命不是只有在这个地球而已，在所有的星球、所有的宇宙都有这个啊生命存在。
There are higher planets and there are higher beings there.With great opulence and powers.
有更高的星球，然后那边的生物有更高的啊，更优越的生活。
And there are lower planets also in the most not very pleasant condition.
也有比地球更低等的星球，然后那边的状况是非常令人不愉快的。
We are on the Earth planet, which is somewhere in the middle of the universe.
我们处在这个地球是在宇宙的中间阶段。
And it's the most convenient place in the universe for developing self-realization.
而且在地球这个层次是最方便来发展、来培养这个自我觉悟。
To go beyond birth and death.
这个自我觉悟最后就是要让我们来超越生死。
So we should take advantage of this life.
所以我们必须要好好应用我们这一世。
This is the best time. This is the Kali Yuga. Kali Yuga is a bad time because there's so many faults in this age. But there's one good thing that just by chanting, you can get all perfection.
那现在卡利年代就是充满了各种错误、纷争等等。但是呢，我们有一个幸运，就是我们可以通过就是念诵这个圣名，克什纳圣名，就可以来超越所有这一切。
So we want to develop the taste for this chanting.
所以我们想要，我们要来培养这种念诵的这种品味。
Taste can come, it may take some time.
会有这个念诵的品味出来，会出现的，但需要一点时间。
But just like the ability to walk is there in the child, when the child is born, the child cannot walk. But gradually, as the child grows and with practice, the child will learn to walk.
就像一个小孩，他是有走路的能力，可是最开始他是有这种潜能，但是需要时间，他会渐渐的可以走，然后走得很稳。
In a similar way, our Krishna consciousness can also develop.
所以同样的道理，我们的 Krishna 自己也是这样子的在发展的。
Follow the practice. Chant, read the books, worship Krishna.
对，就遵循这个程序，念诵呢，研读这个经典，然后崇拜 Krishna.
And worship of Krishna is not very difficult. It doesn't demand a lot.
来崇拜 Krishna 并不困难，并不要求很多。
The Bhagavad Gita, Krishna says, offer a leaf, a flower, a fruit, some water.
佛家梵歌里面说，就是说，用一片叶子啦，一朵花啦，一杯清水啊，Krishna都会接受的。
So, we have leaves. You can see here this tree in the corner, this plant here.It's a tulsi plant, sacred plant.
我们有那个叶呢，就说这个圣树 tulasi 它的叶子可以来供奉。
Yeah, when Krishna says you can offer women leaves from the sacred tree, you can also get this tree if you like to grow some tulsi. You have a place where you get sunlight.
那如果你们自己都要想要种都可以，你可以来栽种，只要说可以有阳光的地方就可以。
Have tulsi at home? And it's a good idea that you can keep tulsi in your home, make your home auspicious. It becomes a holy place.
如果说你是在家里有土拉西的圣树的话，是很好的，让你的家变得吉祥。
And we take a leaf from the tree and can offer to Krishna. And then flowers, you can see Taiwan, they have many nice flowers and they have wonderful fruits everywhere. So these things are easily available to offer to Krishna.
然后花也是，台湾也有很多的不同种类很好的花。
So it's not the offering that Krishna wants, but Krishna wants the devotion. It's the mood with which they're offered.
并不是说 Krishna 要我们给他什么东西，而 Krishna 是要我们这种奉爱，我们在对他供奉的奉爱。
We're trying to cultivate that devotion.
所以我们试着在培养那种那些奉爱。
他讲中文名词还记得啊？禁欲呀，
禁欲麻辣，
禁欲麻辣鸡。
Remember？
禁欲。
你口罩拿下来一下，等一下。
Okay, so we're talking about how easy devotional service is. We want you all to understand very easy process, Krishna consciousness.
所以我们说到了，Krishna 知觉的程序是很容易的，可以知道是那么容易。
And so we encourage all of you try to practice regularly.
所以我们鼓励大家呢。
Just like sometimes we ask people, are you a vegetarian? They'll say, yes, sometimes, or mostly.
就好像我们问你，有时候问人说你吃素吗？有些人就说，有些时候，或者说大部分的时候。
So we encourage, you know, try to follow strict means. Right, all the time, being vegetarian.
所以我鼓励大家都，严格的所有的时候都素食。
make it a habit. And the way to help yourself to keep this habit is by chanting the Hare Krishna mantra.
所以就是吃素也是要让变成习惯，那这个习惯的帮助呢，可以也是从念诵Hare Krishna中可以帮助你。
The most important of all the instructions which we get from Prabhupada is to chant the Hare Krishna mantra.
那我们从Prabhupada那边得到最重要的训示就是来念诵这个Hare Krishna.
Chanting of the Hare Krishna mantra, this is the means to deliver us from the material portion.
那个念诵Hare Krishna是
In this age of Kali, there's no other way. There's no other way.
因为在这卡利年代，再也没有别的方法，再也没有别的方法。
You cannot get out by just karma yoga. There's no karmic activities which will bring you from material life.
我们无法从这个 活动瑜伽或是业报中呢，来脱离物质的海洋。
And there's no Jnana Yoga which will get you out of the
field. 而且没有那个 Jnana Yoga 就是知识方知识的程序来让你脱离这个生死。
And the meditation is also not going to get you out of the
field. 冥想也没有办法让你真的脱离卡利年代。
The only way you can ever get out of this material ocean, material existence in this age is simply by chanting the holy name.
那在这个年代，可以脱离物质的海洋、物质的存在，仅仅的方法就是念诵圣名。
Now there are many names to chant, just like you see here in Taiwan, you know, Omitofo, Omitofo. 很多人说阿弥陀佛。在台湾，很多人都念着阿弥陀佛。 What are they chanting? They're chanting the name of Amitabha Buddha. Actually, the name of the Buddha. They're chanting the name.
那个阿弥陀佛，它梵文是阿弥陀佛，是佛陀中的一位。
But what is their thinking? You know, Buddhism generally, they want to become the Buddha.
那他们念阿弥陀佛那些人他们在想什么？他们一般认为他们念一念自己变成佛了。Their
goal is to become the Buddha.
他们的目标，他们的宗旨是想说变成佛陀。I
was in Guangzhou some few years ago. I met this one. We have this one man there. He's a Buddhist monk. He's 90 something years old. He's a very nice man. Very good friend of our society. So he was asking me one time, he said, you know, in Buddhism, he said, we all want to become the Buddha. So he said, the goal is to enter into the Buddha world, where everyone is the Buddha. So he said, what is it like in Krishna consciousness, in the spiritual world? He said, are there men and women there? Because in Buddhism, everyone becomes a Buddha. There's no man, there's no woman, right? Everybody is Buddha. So, what about Krishna consciousness? Do you have men, women there?
他去广州的时候，有一个佛教的和尚，90几岁了，也是个很好的人，然后跟奉献者也是很接近。 那曾经有一次，那个和尚来问，就是说，说着说着就问说，我们在佛教里面，就是说我们念阿弥陀佛，将来就是要进，我们每个人都希望成为佛，然后我们进到佛国啊，佛境佛国。那么你们这些 Krishna 的人呢，以后去到 Krishna 的那边。 是什么样子？然后有没有男的跟女的？因为他们认为他们到了佛国的时候，大家都是佛了，就不会分男女，就通通都一样的佛。So
I told them in Krishna consciousness there are men and women in the spiritual world.
所以我告诉他说，在 Krishna 知觉里面呢，宁静世界也有男的女的。
And they're very happy together.
而且他们很快乐的在一起。
And the women are all very beautiful also.
而且在宁静世界，女的都很漂亮，很美。
But they're all pure devotees. They all have love for Krishna.
而他们都是纯洁纯粹的奉献者，而且都深爱着 Krishna.
So they're not bewildered by material desire.
而他们不会被物质欲望所迷惑，不会被困惑。
So he was very interesting. We have to understand that there are such conditions where people are not bewildered by the material energy.
我们必须要了解有这样的状况，这种条件就是有一些人是不会受物质能量所困惑的。
Men and women can live together peacefully and happily in Krishna consciousness. By chanting Hare Krishna and by engaging in service to Krishna, we can purify the mind
sensibly. 那么这样子呢，可以净化我们的心意。
Okay, any question?
有什么问题？
好，那我喜欢。Guru Mahārāja， 你刚刚讲到，就是大甲丁现世界有男生女生嘛？那事实上，之前我们也有听过一个课，就是说，其实我圣巴巴的也有回答，是不是在香港？就是说，其实我们。不是男生也不是女生，那有男生女生只是好玩快乐，是这个意思吧？
什么意思？
就我们真正的身份是零，那如果有区分男生女生，其实那在灵性世界只是要增加娱乐，增加那个快乐。
She wants to confirm that you just mentioned in spiritual world there are some male and female, but actually she may read or hear some.We are saying from passing, actually there is no man or woman. It's just because for the lila, for the rasa. Clear by or confirm this point.
I've never heard that there are no men and no women.
Maharaj 没有听过那个叙述，就是没有男的女。
就是灵魂。
Yeah, well, they have spiritual bodies, you could say, because they have spiritual bodies. But their spiritual bodies can be in the form of men and in the form of women.
We can change the way to understand. It's a soul, but the soul can have a man's body and a woman's body. That's different.
对。那所以因为之前就是在美国的时候，不是有一个女的她问说，因为那时候在女权嘛，在倡导即便就是男女要平等，然后有一个她就说，哎，你这个想你这个说法是在鄙视我们女性，然后圣帕帕回答她说，你认为你是女生，你就会觉得你受鄙视。
你认为什么？
If you
think you're a woman, what?
You are looked down. You are being looked down from her answer. If you thought you are the...
Yeah. Okay. That's right. Just like one time there were some black-bodied devotees living in the temple in New York. So this one black devotee, he went to Prabhupada.And he complained to Prabhupada, he said, you know, Prabhupada, he said, people are prejudiced here about black and white bodies.
就另外一个例子说，曾经有一群黑人，my head can 人的奉献者在纽约的庙里面，那么这些黑人奉献者跟泡泡说，好像人们对这个黑人有一种鄙视啊。
So Prabhupada said to him, he said, if you think you're black, then he said, that is your ignorance.
Prabhupada 就对他说，如果你认为你是一个黑人，你是这个黑子，那么你就是在愚昧里面，你是无知的。
That somebody may think you're black and they may be prejudiced, they may not treat you properly, but you should not be influenced, you should not be offended.
如果说有人认为啊你是个黑人，然后看不起你呢，啊对你对待啊不好啊，那你不要受他们影响，因为他是无知的。
But if you're affected by them, then you're also indignant.
那如果包括这个，如果你受他们的影响，那你也是在愚昧。
So Prabhupada was encouraging the black-bodied man to understand.That he's not the body, but he is a soul.
爸爸就在鼓励这个黑人，这个奉献者，就他不是这个身体，他是个灵魂。
So in a similar manner, you can say the same about women. If you think you're a woman, you know, then that's the bodily conception.
所以同样的道理，你可以来看，就是说，如果说认为是个女的话。
At the same time, your love, you have to live in the woman's body, you have to dress accordingly.
在这同时，如果你有一个女子的身体，你就要根据你女子的身体来所谓穿衣服这些事情。
So you have on one hand, externally you're a woman, but at the same time, internally you're not thinking.
所以就是说，在外在呢是一个女的身体，你就要依照你的身体的行为。那但是里面呢又有灵魂的身份，你要记得你是一个灵魂。
对，所以说灵魂它不分男生女生啊。
Yes,
但是
，But yes, 他们不分男。
那到了灵性世界，刚刚有提到，就是那个广州的那个出家人他问的那个问题。就是说，不好意思，我想问清楚，就是灵性世界有分男生女生，那其实那只就是要增加我们的，就是刚刚讲丽拉，就是我们的喜乐嘛，我们灵性的喜乐，所以才会有男生女生之分嘛。
嗯，
对不起，我再次回到那个药。
Come back to that point, mention to the monk in Guangzhou that in the spiritual world there is a female.So that's, she asked, that's only for the Lila, Rasa. So they are the form of male and female.
Yeah, everything is for the pleasure of Krishna.
一切都是为了 Krishna 的快乐而进行的。
对吗？是这个意思吗？
She's not, I think she wants to keep the point about the soul does, has no.
But that still there are men and women there in the spiritual world.
不是我们认为灵魂是男的或女的，没有男女之分。可是，在灵性世界还是有男的阳性跟阴性，男女形体。
Not only are there men and women, they're all different species of life. They're all there in the spiritual.
不只说有人的这种像人，我们人这种样子，男女的。而且所有种类的生物也有
动作，有
阳性跟阴性的生物，
对，但是它是有自觉的那种灵性，就是要增加，就是那个灵性的快乐，那只是一个更丰富的这个。
Yeah.
对，那我还可以再
多请一声，
就刚突袭啊，Maharaj 就刚刚讲那个在达摩达尔月的时候。因为我家就是之前香港的庙长月亮跑不来，就是用那个已经枯萎的、已经死掉的、已经离开的那个托拉西的那个树枝，好，然后把它弄成酥油灯，然后在达摩达尔月的时候供奉， 供灯啊。
嗯。
那平常可以吗？
嗯。
平常一样可以这样吗？嗯。
The Tulsi branch to put the
Indian
people.
Okay.
可以。可以啊。哦。那 only.
继续，不要还有人要问吧，因为我还有。
你去继续。
真的。
那那个，您提到那个，您被问过说，你不是印度教徒，那您的回答是说我是修习放在底下，那这个也是我最大困扰。比如说我们出去哈瑞纳，我们穿的比较像印度，我们穿沙粒嘛，所以。常常人家就认定啊，你是印度徒，通常我都很难回答，因为如果我说我在修习放瑜伽，我要从零开始一直在解释，那所以变成说我们在派书的时候很难去在短时间去把这个具体化的答案给予，所以我就会不知道怎么办这样子。
Well, you could tell them these are the clothes of the spiritual world. Well, yeah, I mean, you have to explain to them that.These clothes, they help us to practice simple living, natural way of life. It takes away the clothes are meant to take away the bodily consciousness, and to help us to have more spiritual consciousness, to help us to identify more as a devotee of Krishna, just like a policeman.How do you know he's a policeman? He has his uniform. So the devotee of Krishna has his dress. You can recognize him.
就是说穿这些这类的这样的衣服是让我们来简化我们的生活。
是吗？
就简化。
对。
把我们生活简化，而且是比较自然的。这样的方式。这样子。就好像说如果要辨认警察就是有他的制服一样来看。
And she asked how to explain to people we are not Hindus, but Bhakti Yoga seems to have to start from zero for people to get idea. But we also say we are not Hindus. They couldn't get.
Yeah, well, we have to explain to them that actually.The word Hindu, there's no Hindu word in the, anywhere in any scripture.
在任何经典上都没有印度教这个字。
但是我们怎么解释？跟一般不熟悉的人。
Outside Harina and distribute books, not so much time.
Well, you just tell them that this is just like the policeman, the uniform.
那就只是跟他们说啊，我们这是奉献者的这个衣服的制服一样，像警察制服一样。
But how do you recognize the policeman? Has his police uniform?
警察就是因为他有制服，所以可以看得出。
So this is the uniform. This is the dress of the boat.
The term about religion, they may keep on thinking Hinduism. So bring them to Bhakti Yoga. It's a long story for them.
Yeah, how to tell people this is not Hinduism? Well, just like Prabhupada was saying, he said, I'm the only Hindu, everybody else was not Hindu. I'm not Hindu, you know, I'm not a Hindu. I'm not from India.
Oh, my God. 不是印度教徒。对，我不是印度教徒，你们也不是印度教徒。
因为 Prabhupada 去美国的时候，他只有他是印度教，其他的
就
是他的门徒都是美国人。
他
说除了我以外，没有什么印度教人。我们都是信 Hare Krishna， 他们是美国人，他们不是印度教。
我
这
样遇到这个问题，但是我都跟他说我在修习破坏瑜伽。我们这个是瑜伽，心灵层面的瑜伽，因为他们第一个直接会说，哦，是那个体位瑜伽什么，说不是，也不是禅定明的瑜伽冥想，也不是，就是破坏瑜伽属于心灵层面的。然后我们有经典，有波切梵歌，啊，有圣莲波切瓦他。我现在都以这种方式去解释，我不跟他讲说是印度教徒是不是之类的，我都跟他修行瑜伽、破坏瑜伽、Bhakti Yoga。会接受，因为现在太多人在修瑜伽，可是都是体位的。对啊，就直接跟他讲，我这是心灵层次的瑜伽，这样。还有人要问？
没有问题。那问题，你问我们妈妈那个颜色，我们说瑜伽教。以前我妈，我一说不在家的时候，人家打电话过来问，我妈就说啊瑜伽教，
哈哈哈
哈哈，也不知道怎么说，啊，哲学又太复杂。
那我在问，就是你们要不要问？因为我要，就是说我常常听到我们常主餐他妈不也讲，就是说。你不要去冒犯奉献者，你冒犯奉献者，我不会原谅。那我就一直在想，因为常常听到、看到，都一直在讲这件事，所以我突然有想，这个好像就在家里面，如果你可能对父亲有冒犯，可是无论如何，父亲都会原谅你。可是当你对别人不 OK 的时候，如果这个父亲真的是父亲的时候，他会骂他的孩子，你这样是错的，而且会很，应该说很严厉的斥责他的孩子。我认为，Krishna 还是主查他妈帕布的这些，就是你是奉献者，你就是我的人，你是我的孩子，所以，我就是要严厉的告诉你，你这样是不对的。我的理解以及体悟是这样，这 Maharaj 这样对。
often mentioned do not offend devotees. This point keep up coming. She has the understanding that as a like a Lord, Krishna already accepts us. So it's like a father, more strict. Because when the children offend the father, father will always forgive the child. But when the child offends others, then the father will be strict on that child. Correct that person. Correct the child, say this is not right. So like that. That's why Lord Chaitanya, Lord Krishna is very serious on the offending this case. It's like she wants to see if that's right or not, her point. Like parents will correct the child more heavily than do others.
Well, yeah, Krishna takes offenses against his devotees more serious than he does offenses against himself.
Okay. Krishna 对于奉献者冒犯的 Krishna 他没有看得那么认真，但是如果奉献者冒犯的奉献者 Krishna 就看得很认真。
We give the example. You can tolerate the heat of the sun.On your head, but you cannot tolerate on your feet. Sometimes, if you go on the hot sand in the summertime, the sand will be so hot, you can't tolerate the heat of the ground on your bare feet. If you walk barefoot, the ground is so hot, you can't tolerate, but you can tolerate on your head, but not on the sole of your feet.
就是说同样的热 如果照在我们头上，有时候你出去海滩啊，头顶还可以晒那么热，可是你脚踏在那个海滩的沙太烫了，你受不了。
So the same way Krishna can tolerate offenses against himself, but he cannot tolerate offenses against his devotees. The devotees have taken shelter at his lotus feet.
所以 Krishna 可以容忍对他的冒犯啊，但是他奉献者托庇于他的足下呢，所以他不会没办法容忍别人去冒犯这个奉献者。
Oh, there's the mad elephant offense.
那就是有那个疯狂大象那种冒犯啊。
The offended devotees.
冒犯奉献者。
Krishna can tolerate offense against himself, but not against his devotees.
Krishna 可以原谅，可以容忍奉献者的这个冒犯，但他不会去容忍哈。别人冒犯他的奉献者。
So Krishna is like the father, the devotees are like his dear children.
所以 Krishna 就像父亲，奉献者就像他的孩子，他亲爱的孩子。
那。我再问一个问题，就是我爸是妈妈讲的那个四阶层。
你说哪个四阶层？
就社会四阶层啊。
啊啊啊！
我爸是妈妈的那四阶层，就是对对对。这个四阶层，因为我现在在看着一本。
罗马样的。
然后它这里有就是有一个地方。达小拉塔他后来就是他需要忍受跟 Rama 离别之苦，是因为他过去有做错一件事，就是在他当年轻王子的时候，因为他具有一个非常神秘的力量，他只要听到声音他就知道那个他就有办法射箭把那个标的物把他射死，然后就有一天他晚上的时候误杀了一个年轻人，他在提水要提回家，那他的父母亲木马，那他死了之后，这个年轻人就跟达小拉塔王说，那你现在就要帮我提水回去，然后跟他爸妈说他已经被他射死误杀了嘛，但是就是在这同时，这个年轻人告诉达小拉塔王说，你放心，我的父亲不是婆罗门，然后他父亲是 Vaisya， 他的妈妈是 Sutra， 对，然后到了他家之后呢，因为双亲都木盲，所以他以为达小拉塔王是他儿子提水回来的，就很开心，大家跟他聊聊，后来达小拉塔还是很忍不住的，就告诉他实情，说你的儿子被我误杀了，种种这样。那这个父亲，这个木盲的父亲，就告诉达小拉塔王说，因为你诚实的承认你杀了我，误杀了我的孩子，所以我会饶你一命。然后他这里就有写到。可是到最后他还是诅咒他，对，这个木马的父亲还是诅咒达小拉塔，就是说你以后也会遭受跟我同样跟儿子离别之苦，就是拉玛被流放嘛，到森林里面14年。那我就想，因为常常听到说圣人在诅咒还是那个
婆罗门
诅咒，还有就是各类型的诅咒，那这些诅咒都会成真。Maharaj， 就说别人像这种状况，就是因为他误杀了他的孩子，他很痛苦，但是 虽然他饶了他一命，可是他还是给他诅咒了，那诅咒都会应验。性其实都是很高的，不是不管你是不是扫地的，还是你的职位是婆罗门还是萨提利嘛，就说各个所谓的社会阶层，其实大家都在灵性上都是非常高的。我是想要，其实重点我想要理解这一点，以及加上就是说，哎，这种你对就是刚刚讲那种例子，然后他任何人哦的诅咒都会成真吗？就这两个问题。
对啊，我想要把它消化一下。那个第二个部分，第二个诅咒刚问，然后再来，没，你问第二个问题问的方式，应该是说，是不是各个阶层
的
专职，各个阶层他们做的很好，都是纯粹的灵性的，是不是？都是很进步的这个意思。
就是这个所谓的社会式阶层，
我大概知道你的意思，我知道你的意思，只是说那个句子because the Dasharath being cursed the next life to be the same encounter
he died without his son
because the parents of that child previous life was notThey were not Brahmana, but they have this power to curse her. So she wants to know any kind of people can give curse, and the curse will really manifest for them.
Well, it's karma. Whether they curse or not, you're going to get karma.
所以无论有没有诅咒，那是他的业报。
Krishna 来决定。
Well, material nature.
大自然，大自然。
The laws of material.
自然定律就会这么做，你会得到那个回应。自然定律，自然会安排。
Because Maharaj Dasaratha killed someone.
因为 Dasaratha 他杀了那个。
He killed that young man.
他杀掉那个。
And the young man was taking care of his parents.
他照啊对，就是。他杀掉那个在照顾父母亲的这个男孩，所以他有这个因，下一次会接受这个果。
You get karma.
是他得到的业报，就是不论他有没有他的父母的诅咒。
然后刚就是我提的那个社会那个四阶层啊，其实就是要应该说是要去搭配那个灵性四阶段，然后呢其实不管你哪一个阶层，你总是到最后你会灵性会提升到那个层面去。
你把那个层面
就是说不是啊，社会灵性四阶段嘛，就是真守生25岁，然后50岁居士嘛，50岁这就退出家庭嘛，然后再就闪离亚西啦，然后再就是什么，
云游正在
不对对、就是这样子的一个阶段，就不管这个社会式阶层是怎么样，你要来过这个所谓的灵性式阶段的人生阶段。
你刚刚那个是灵性的，那社会阶段就是白夏苏抓了。
对，就是不管你的社会是阶层，你的阶层是哪一个阶层，但是你如果遵循灵性式阶段的时候，哪怕你是一个扫地的、扫厕所的，其实跟那一个所谓的社会基层的婆罗门，其实到最后都是一样的，他们已经穿越了这个所谓的超越这个物质层面，然后来到灵性的那个最高的百斯拉瓦的层面，是这样吗？
对，你说 both from Vanai Ashram they match properly, perform their duty according to regulations, they will all come elevate to that spiritual platform. Is that whether one is a Shukra, Vaisha, or
Shukra. Yeah, of course.
But at the same time, they also in the this Brahmacharya, Grihastha, or Vanaprastha.
In the spiritual world, they don't have these things.
在灵性世界没有这些阶级。
对对对对。但是现在因为大家就被这个物质能量那个嘛，然后就是旧定位，其实社会世阶层就摆出来了。但是灵性四阶段是圣人给予的，如果可以照着这样的阶段的时候，我们灵性就可以提升到最后，其实最高的时候大家都一样。对，
应该我懂，但是有一部分我不能确定你就说你说因为我物质能量影响，所以我们有这个物质的社会阶层。那你说又圣人给的这四个灵性阶段啊？
对，所以我们得以不管你是哪个阶层，只要你遵循着这样的灵性的这个阶段的时候，大家都会提升到超越这个物质能量。
Krishna Yeshua.
对。
Bhagavad Gita, Krishna Yeshua.
因为。
Shriya Vaishas Tathasudra Steti Yanti Parambati. Even you be of lower birth, you can attain the supreme destination.
Krishna in the Buddha Panda says, 即便你是出身低微的层次，你也是可以提升到这个最高的灵性世界。
对，因为我就是读那个彩太阳马哈帕布，我忘记我读哪里，就是。就是说那个 Sridhar 就是那个卖香蕉种香蕉卖香蕉的，就是在马哈帕布在很小时候你卖的时候啊，他就专爱去街道上买这个 Sridhar 的芭蕉的香蕉。然后呢那时候他还小嘛，后来他就长大了，主裁方长大之后啊，他就开始倡导这个 Kirtan 开始聚众了嘛。然后但是一开始是秘密的，那有一天呢他就告诉他夫人说，你去把水道给叫过来，因为呢他这个是他重要的人物。然后呢原来我的意思是说，我读到他这个逍遥时光的这一些人水道的时候，我就觉得就是那个要点就是他完全的水道对主裁他麻布的那个真爱，所以主裁他麻布就是在秘密的这种联谊的时候，就把他叫来一起联谊，然后当场就拥抱他说，就因为他要给他祝福，他说他不要，他说他不要这个祝福，他不要任何祝福，他说我只要拥有你以前小时候那个你卖来我的摊位买芭蕉香蕉叶的那个过程。那个是他要的祝福，其他他完全都不要。所以我的意思说，这证明了就是，其实哪怕一个扫地扫厕所的啦，然后他是一个就是农夫嘛，种芭蕉，可是都可以得到这么多人的里面，但是得到了主禅他麻巴布的召见，然后把他涌入怀中。他说，因为当时候他就已经要给他，就是他说你房子这么破，穿得这么破，别人过得那么好，你为什么不卖贵一点什么？然后他就说，我这样就好了，我这样就够了，我其他的钱就是捐到就是恒河的祭祀嘛。对，然后那时候主台妈妈就说，你一定有什么秘密啊。后来就在他召见他的时候，他就说，对啊，你的秘密就是这个宝藏，你今天终于说出来了。然后他就很开心的拥抱他。对不起，我的，因为我觉得这非常甜美的一个故事。
这个马尔西很熟，所以我不用翻。
对，哦、那
这些内容马尔西很
对、啊、
很清楚，所以我不用去翻译。
所以我个人觉得，就是我们身处这个物质世界，我们在做生意啊，当 但是也有人啊，也有的奉献者，他会说，我是已经 Krishna 的人，我不过世俗的生活，然后呢，就是说他没有在做买卖就对了。我心里就有点
冲击呀、
啊，也不是说什么冲击，就是他说他已经是 Krishna 的人了，他不做买卖，他不参与世俗的东西。那 Saridhara 怎么讲？我觉得 Saridhara 他的这种胸怀，他这种爱啊，就是会让我觉得。
Some devotees say they are already devotees, so they don't touch material things, they don't do business. So she feels it don't be uneasy because from this banana vendor story, so Chaitanya is still doing the.
Wow, you can pay 50% to Guru
Krishna. 做生意50%来服务 Krishna.
小分 pharmacy, you know that.
Yeah, she and her ex-husband, late husband was opposed to her husband. He's a pharmaceutist. So they opened the pharmacy. And she also has a place growing many vegetables and fruits. In her mother's house, the older land.
You don't know.
我怎么不知道You know, do they use bad language? You know, how serious is it?
他们吵是多严重？只是嘴巴骂一骂，还是说有诅咒，还是说两个打起来了？
哈哈哈哈
哈！程度如何？
没有诅咒，就是可能吵架，意见不合，然后就是口角这样算冒犯吗？这样不算。
大家那么客气都没有问题啊，可以问下什么？对，可以跟林信老师聊聊。马拉姐，就是我想要了解马拉姐，现在您已经都在吃埃卡达西的餐嘛？像您现在都吃埃卡达西的餐，所以说这个餐的体，就是说不同的这样子的一个修行的层次的时候，吃的餐慢慢就会有一种。就是会比较，这应该叫纯净一点的食物哈。所以说，像我们这样，我们是不是也要跟着，就是说学习，就是饮食上面也要开始学习比较这样子的一个简化，对我们的灵性知觉，或者是就是说这样会有比较有帮助。所以，就是说我们不同的层级的那个食物会有不一样，会造成不同的这个层级的关系，是吗？嗯。
我也想过这个问题。
还有就是马上就
有发高音的 ，Ekadasi， so she wants to know that because of future more progress more advanced, that we be more selective or more simplify our diet, and there's any difference from our regular eating?
No, 我们是。就是应该遵循说自然的层次到了的时候这样吃，还是说我们应该是就是最终的我们像比如说来跟随马拉吉这样子的吃，对我们会是比较好的。
What would be better follow as nature progressed, or we just now like following with you those ecstasy?
Well, the main thing is you eat for Krishna.
重点是你为 Krishna 而吃。
You know what you like to eat and what you don't like.
你知道你喜欢吃什么，不喜欢吃什么。
You know when you dress for others.
当你我们的穿着啊是为了别人而穿。
But when you eat for yourself.
那吃东西是为了自己而吃。
So it's up to you what you like.
就看你要怎么来吃。
How you feel comfortable. how your body feels.
让你身体觉得怎么样的舒适的那种。
马拉吉的意思是说，每个人都不一样，体质也不同，就是说要看状况。
看你觉得你适合那些食物怎么样。
所以这样饮食是对身体，是对身体的部分，身体的部分。并不是说为了因为灵性的提升知觉去做这样子的一个饮食。
So the food mainly for the body. Yeah,
it's from the body.
Not for spiritual.
No.
谢谢
各位尽量的问哦，因为马拉吉的饮食
很久没有来，
马拉吉的饮食的时间我们会比较晚一点，所以大家还有时间。那因为我现在也还要再去做几道菜，所以说大家继续在这里可以再跟马拉吉多闲聊，可以吗？马拉吉，
可以。
你们继续要闲聊，不用太拘谨啦，马拉吉，
进去，
在的。
这一层楼有没有洗手间？我忘了。
洗手间。
这一层楼有没有洗手间？
我忘了。下楼下。
楼下哈，我知道楼下的，但这一层我忘了。
哎，这个
洗手间
太冷了。
经典啊，
你有带吗？
有。
哦，那你可以请他给你寄。
那些心里想要去做的，你不要让他做。
The mind says, "Oh, don't." The mind, woman is singing, "Oh, 不能念诵啊，昨天已经念诵，今天你不用念诵，你可以休息一下。
强强一直告诉这个心意不能这样子，要怎么样？这样子就是在打他的意思。
早上我们应该起床，可是我们的心里说，哦，多睡一点，时间还很早，不用那么早起。不用念钟啊，你可以多睡啊。所以不能听我们的心里，
不要听心里说。
如果不要听心意说，那是智力告诉他的。
When we say "Don't listen to the mind," that is the intelligence telling us.
Yeah. Okay.
嗯，是的。
那这样，那灵魂他做了什么
？Well, the some desires coming from the soul also.There's some desire also there. The desire of the soul, the soul can choose surrender to Krishna or surrender to mind.
所以灵魂还是有这个他的愿望存在，所以灵魂可以选择他要去向 Maya 臣服呢，还是向这个 Krishna 臣服。灵魂可以来有这个意愿，他选择什么？
这个是我们的自由，我们可以自己选择。To be Krishna, to be Maya. 如果我们选择 to be Maya, 所以这三种心态进来。愚昧心态、轻蔑心态。
那也就是说，像刚刚丽娜讲的，就是自信叫心意去做，那实际上是灵魂发出那个愿望，然后自信再转而去控制到了那个，就是心意，让心意去执行，去那个嘛。
So she's confirming.
So
it's the soul have this desire and telling the intelligent going to.Tell the mind to do this or not, like that. The way, the process, yeah, the step or the process of the mind from this first because of our desire, and then our intelligence would get it and tell the mind to do this or not. This.
Yeah, intelligence. But intelligence is seated next to the soul.
Mm.
So it gets a lot of inspiration from the soul.
Mm. 我们的智力，我们的智性就坐在，等于是坐在灵魂的旁边，所以我们的智力从灵魂那边得到很多的灵感。
嗯，那超灵就是 Krishna， 那这样的，就是说，当这个愿望生出来之后。超灵 Krishna 就会给出能量，比如说，像我，我到时候就是在弄那个，因为我先就走了嘛，
嗯，
然后我接了这个药局，然后又那块地，然后我就站在那里，站在那块，我就想，那我怎么办？然后我就看到那些草，我想到这些草，哎，这些是药草，可以煮成青草茶，
嗯。
然后我就开始把它拔回去，拔回去药局。那就是说这些动作，以及让它整个变成一个很实体的，就是说我真的在执行这件事情，对吧？就是整个即使也是 Krishna 的帮助，让我就是药局的运作。就根据我的愿望，我那个灵魂的愿望，然后 Krishna 给了我能量，然后让它成真，这样子，对吧？
嗯。She wants to confirm her thought is right or not. When she has desire, so Krishna give energy to fulfill. Like when her husband passed away, left this pharmacy.And a piece of land. So she was also a little bit bewildered, confused, not sure what to do, but she saw there the land, they have some grass and herb. So she thinks, oh, that she can make the herbal tea. And then she keep taking care of the pharmacy. So it's that Krishna give her the ability and fulfill desire also. She want to confirm this idea.It's from Krishna give her the...
Yes, but it could also be the influence of the modes of nature.
除了是 Krishna 给你这个能量或力量，也有可能也是由于物质属性、物质能量的属性的影响。
It's not what you do, but it's the mood you do it in. Are you doing it for Krishna?
不是说你做了什么，而是你的心态、你的心境是在为 Krishna 而做吗？
Maybe you think I can do that. I can make money this way.
或者你有想说哦，我可以用这个方式来赚钱。
So that's not Krishna. That's the mode of nature.
那个时候就不是 Krishna， 是物质能量的让你去做。
We have to. Oh no, you have to think like that. You have to think how to make money.
就是我们。在生活中必须要去想要怎么有赚钱来过生活，所以但是那个在物质能量的部分。
不做这个炒茶，因为我觉得这个最接近 Krishna。我认为以我药师的这个，我是觉得这个最接近 Krishna， 因为它就是什么 Prasadam 嘛。然后我有很多人来买，然后我得到钱，然后也可以做到服务。但是有时候我会跟 Krishna 讲说 ，Krishna 如果这个是对的，请你告诉我，让我知道这个是你要我做的。而且我会不会讲得太私密？我跟 Krishna 的关系。
Yeah, but you have to give the result to Krishna. You have to give the result to Krishna.
而你要把你工作的成果献给 Krishna。
对。
Not just doing something, but it's the give the result to Krishna also.
不是说只有做一些事，而是要把那个结果献给 Krishna。
我想
要
请问，所谓的献给 Krishna 是指心意上，是说我们口头上还是心念？我不知道所谓的献给 Krishna 是。
She want to know.We say offer to Krishna is just mentally, or we just speak like that, or what does that mean to offer to Krishna? The real item, or just mentally?
Well, just like when you cook something, and then we offer it to Krishna. How do we offer it to Krishna? We will take some of the...whatever we cook, and we'll place it on the altar, and we'll chant the mantras.
就像我们煮东西、做饭，然后煮菜，我们就去拿实际的材料去煮，然后煮好了来供奉给 Krishna。
那像他刚刚说的，他赚钱，然后去做服务，怎样叫做做你所做的？因为佛家上不是说我们所做每件事都要献给 Krishna， 那除了这些形式上的，那我们心意上的是不是说，我今天做了，我例如我写一本书，或是我今天做了一件事情，做任何事情我都跟主说，主啊，我把这件事情献给你，这个结果献给你吗？是这个意思吗？
Like this.Her case is like earning money, and then how to offer money to Krishna. And if another side is in our mind, in our heart, like she said, like writing a book, and while doing that in the mind, in the heart, saying, oh Krishna, I'm doing this for you, I'm offering to you. It's like that or not?
Well, yes, that's also there. I'm doing this for Krishna, for you, I'm offering to you.But you have to actually also give it to Krishna.
所以是有这样子，就是说心，我们的心意有这样子说，Krishna为你而做，我贡献给你，但是也是要什么实质的结果也贡献给Krishna。
How will you give it to Krishna?
你怎么样来给？
Maybe you go and you buy fruits and you bring the fruits and you offer the fruit to Krishna.
比方说，你也可以买水果，然后供奉水果。
Or maybe there's some monk wants to build a temple, so you may give some donation to the monk for the building of the temple.
或者说有一些和尚他们要盖庙，你可能捐一些钱给他们盖庙。
因为那个国家范本里面说，将所有的活动都献给主嘛。所以我的意思是说，我是指要怎样叫做所有的活动献给主。这句话我。
In Bhagavad Gita saying like one offer, even activity, offer everything to Krishna. So she wants to know how to offer everything.
Well, everything is body, mind, and words.
供奉于就是我们的身体，我们的心意，我们的言语。
So you use your body to do service for Krishna.
用我们的身体来做服务，给 Krishna 做服务。
And with your mind, you think about Krishna.
要用心意来想，心意来用来想 Krishna.
And the words, you chant Hare Krishna, or you sing songs about Krishna, or you speak about Krishna.
所以言谈话语就是说，来念诵、唱诵 Krishna 这一些祈祷文歌曲啊，还有讲述 Krishna 啦这些东西。
Would you like to give everything to Krishna?
你会想，你愿意要把一切都贡献给 Krishna 吗？
你像穿布托比一样。
我想补充一下，刚才就说，刚才妹妹说了一句，将你所做的一切都奉献给主 Krishna， 但是这里面有个迷思，就是说，除非像 Maharaj 说的。的身心灵全部从事于对于
服务，对于托卖服务有关系的，这个才能够算嘛。那我们每天每个人所做的每一件事情，不见得会跟这个主题什么或者是服务有关系，所以这个就不能算，对不对？
That statement have to be need more clarified. She's saying that 一切把一切贡献给 Krishna. So whatever we do, whatever we offer to Krishna, and she said whatever we do, the whole day may be something not related to Krishna. So in that case, how to say everything to Krishna?
Well.The point is, if somebody is giving everything to Krishna, then everything will be related to Krishna. But if they're doing something which is not connected to Krishna, then they haven't fully surrendered.
这个要点是，如果一个人他把一切都贡献给 Krishna 的话，就是说他所有的一切都是跟 Krishna 有关系的。但是如果一个人他不是贡献一切给 Krishna， 就是说他有一些东西是跟 Krishna 没有关系的事。
So in the Bhagavad Gita, Krishna talks about karma yoga, and then in karma yoga, there's the verse which you're talking about. All that you do, all that you eat, all that you offer and give away, done as an offering to me.
那在《薄伽梵歌》里面有一个部分特别讲到。业报瑜伽或活动瑜伽哈，这个名称就是说里面内容就像刚刚我们说到，你所做的一切，你所吃的哈，你所
all that you offer and give away，
你所有的贡献，或是说你所有的布施，这一切
all austerity，
所有的苦行哈
should be done as an offering to me。
这一切呢都应该是当作是贡献，要供奉给 Krishna 的，这样来进行。
That's karma yoga. That's not bhakti yoga.
那个情况还算是 karma yoga， 还不是奉爱瑜伽。
Because the thinking I'm giving this.
因为那个还有在想着说，是我给，我供奉的，我给的。
But karma yoga can offer.
看怎么样？
可以奉献吗？
Can one offer the karma yoga?
Yeah, you can offer, but it's not bhakti yoga.
可以的，但还不是奉爱瑜伽。
还没有奉爱瑜伽呢吗？
所以我刚才就说有个名词哈，就是说我们每个人每天做的不见得每一件事情都是跟主菩萨有关系。
So she said it's a little bit puzzling because we are not at that level to complete relate everything with Krishna.
Yes, so we have to go to other yoga.
所以，因为就是我们知道我们所做不完全是在奉爱。还在这个业报瑜伽里面，所以我们就要继续遵守规范，继续的提升。
There's some karma yoga. Krishna says in the Bhagavad Gita, in the 12th chapter, Krishna's describing different stages of the world.
那Krishna在《薄伽梵歌》第十二章就描述，就是说不同阶段的奉爱。不同阶段的奉献。
So he begins to describe the highest level that you think of Krishna constantly without any deviation.
最开始描述到就是说，最高阶段就是说，你恒常不断的冥想着 Krishna， 而且没有偏离。
And if you can't do that, then Krishna practices the regulative principles of Bhakti Yoga.And develop a desire to come to me.
那么接着可想说，如果没办法这样做到的话，那就规律的去实践奉爱啊。然后 培养出这个要到达完全这样的奉爱。
So what are the regular principles of Bhakti Yoga?
奉爱瑜伽的规范原则是什么？
It's not just no meat, fish and eggs.
啊，并不是说只有是没有鱼肉蛋这样的
事。It's not just, you know, four regular principles.
嗯，说到不是只有这个四个规范守则。
That's for everybody.
那是最所谓最开始的这个。
这个规范是所有的文明的人。
哦，是给所有文明的人，就是要这样四遵守四个规范的。
But the principles of Bhakti Yoga are worshipping Krishna, read the books about Krishna, and chanting Hare Krishna.
所以要做九项奉爱服
务。nine items of devotional service.
Yeah. And if you can't follow the regular principle of Bhakti Yoga, then you should try to do Karma Yoga.
如果没有办法到那个规范，至少要试着做的 Karma Yoga 业报瑜伽。
Karma Yoga means offering the results of your work to Krishna.
Karma Yoga 意思就是说把我们所做的活动的结果来贡献给 Krishna.
Maybe you have a job, you make some money, so you give something, you donate something to the temple.
就比方说如果你有工作，然后就把工作的一些所得来贡献给庙宇这样子。
Something like that.
诸如此类的。
And if you can't do that, then there's others. There's okay. Then if you can't give to Krishna, sometimes people are opposed. No, you don't want to give this. So you do some other welfare work. Give for the poor people, or give for the old people, or do some kind of charity.
但是有时候有人会觉得，哦，为什么要给 Krishna？ 会反对。做不到那样子吗？那你也可以做一些慈善，啊，做一些慈善给一些机构啊，啊，贫穷的啦，救助的啦，什么这些机构做一点那个慈善的。
但是这个物质方面的善举应该算是一种。
Yes, it's not spiritual.
对，
不是灵性的，
那不是物质的。
But it helps us to become detached. It's allowing us to develop.
这样去布施是帮助我们来弃绝，不会去这样子哈执着。
We need to get detached.
我们必须要弃绝，要放下。
就是，对，破坏服从舌头开始嘛，就是对啊。啊，我们要空调菩萨的吗？就是只要照他，就是我们得到的那些钱，然后去买菜，然后空调，然后供奉，好，然后荣耀菩萨的，然后虔诚念诵，然后阅读经典，然后去推动菩萨自觉运动，去帮助人家来认识菩萨。那这样子就是因为刚刚 Lila 讲的。有时候好像类似有点，就是是不是有一些空窗期没有跟 Krishna 连接上？你的意思是这样？啊，那些空窗期就是
没有。我的意思是说，因为不见得每一个人啊，每天
哦，对，
因为这是事实啊。
但如果是为了 Krishna 而工作，其实这些都已经在这里面了，因为只要。那个就算是一种很超然的一种冥想的状态，以及刚刚我讲的那种最很实际的去落地实践的那个那个真实，就画瑜伽
所以就没有刚讲的那些所谓的卡玛优伽那些状况，就已经来到奉爱了嘛，对不对？如果我刚刚讲的这样的程序，如实的去做的时候
，If we once income going to get the She says devotion service start from the tongue, so we honor prasadam, and like we go to get the boga, cooking and offering to Krishna, and then also we are chanting and reading the books and go to preach. So this, in this way, there is no space for the karma yoga, so it's fully engaged in the Bhakti yoga, that she wants to confirm.
Well, the Bhakti yoga is that mode that we're doing it for Krishna and everything is given to Krishna.
奉爱瑜伽是在于我们的心态，我们是为 Krishna 而做，然后把一切都献给 Krishna.
Yeah, the attitude is the important.
重点在于这个态度。
然后我们要自己要去想办法去让你的刚刚讲的感官，那五个感官包括心意，就是在看到东西在拿到东西的时候就想到 Krishna，
就是
我们自己要想办法
训练，要一些知识so we have to
we have to think that it's all Krishna. You see the flower, I think this is Krishna'sIn the material world, the man has a flower, he will give it to his wife, you know, or girlfriend or whatever. But the devotee will give to Krishna.
就是我们试着练习去想到，就像看到花，就是说这个花可以献给 Krishna， 给 Krishna 是属于 Krishna。可是如果世俗人可能就拿来给老婆啊，给自己的女朋友或做什么其他的。
Your man is working in the bank.So he's counting a lot of money every day, but it's not his money, it belongs to the bank.
如果说一个人在银行工作，他每天在数钱，可是那个钱不是他的，是属于政府的，或是银行的。
The same way, the devotee is seeing everything, it's Krishna's problem.
同样的道理，奉献者就会看，所有一切都是 Krishna 的所有啊资产。
因为我分享一个我自己个人，因为我那时候去就是在妈布以及去普里加格拉普里的时候，那会有一些菜市场嘛，就是像拉瓦对普的菜市场，还是加格拉在普里的菜市场，然后在破格兰的时候，我就冲去那个他们有在卖那个厨具锅铲，然后我就给他买回来，然后当我在 cooking 的时候。我就会，当我触碰到那个铲子、那个锅子，我就立即我的思绪就会想到加加纳的普里的那个大庙、那个菜市场，然后哇，像我现在我这样描述，可是我就已经立刻跑到那里去，然后有时候哎，这个是在拉瓦对普的菜市场买的，就是那种喜悦，就是让我觉得很棒很棒，所以。就是如果我去到圣地，就是已经提供了这些，但是可能我们自己要去想到，这是我的分享，就是想到这样子，因为感官对象，所以当你看，然后又拿到，然后又开始烹调的时候，然后又煮出来的时候，整个能量场全部都是在那个氛围的状态。
没有了。Yeah, she bought the cooking ware from Jagannath Puri and also some from Navadvip. So now, when she's cooking using these utensils, she immediately think of Jagannath Puri and think of Navadvip. So she means we have to make our conscious connected.
Yeah, you're right.
Maharaj, you从马普回到家多久了？
马普回到什么？
回到马哈拉吉的家。对。
Maybe about.
我没有听见。
Navadvip Parikrama Dashal for which Mayapur. 去年我离开马普。
对不起，是很彪吗？不是啦，就是一个艺术创作者，那他创作的这些作品，就是让他自己觉得他的艺术创作也非常的很讶异，然后他会想到这哪来的这么强大的一个
灵感，
对，让他有这么样的一个作品，就是他是我表弟，他是一个艺术工作者，所以应该说现在是要就是要跟 Krishna 连接起来，那可能是你要不要问啊，你可以问灵性导师啊，
啊，
不用问，因为他现在就是想说可以透过来认识 Krishna， 然后为 Krishna 做一点事情，以及透过他的作品，但可是因为他现在才刚接触，
那他是哪一艺术的哪一个部分，哪一个方面？
他有绘画跟雕刻，绘画跟雕刻，
石雕还是木雕哈？
釉雕
啊，
那个
釉
釉子，
对
对对，
You know he is her，
你可以问，
不要不可以，
对。
He
is an artist, paintings and also some carving, but carving in the pomegranate. I don't know how. And she said that sometimes the artist will be amazed. The work is so fantastic. So that is from Krishna. That's what she said. 然后呢？
应该是说可能
你要确认还是询问还是要
那是他想的，
不是我想的，你自己要因为你想要做点服务啊，因为
she want to,
他这些让他觉得
he wants to offer
连他自己不可能做出来，可是他做出来一些东西
to offer for Krishna so maybe his skill
his skill
就是要把他的才艺来做一点服务吧，是这个意思吧？
对，
是画画还是什么？还是你要马上去建议？还是说他有要自己已经确认的方式了？
你可以给 Maharaj 看一下你的作品。
我刚刚听下来，我在想，他是不是想问说如何，就是他帮他问的问题，就是说如何落透，通过他的专长，他的艺术这个专长来跟 Krishna 做连接，他想问 Maharaj 这个问题吗？
我是觉得
你是不是要这样子问？
是要做连接还是做
创作要跟 Krishna 有关吗？
就是如果通过他的专长，通过他的那个他的作品来，
他自己讲，
来跟Krishna联系。
应该是说我接到这个创作的这个讯息下来的那个当下，有一个声音告诉我说，这件事不是给我自己玩的，是要给大家玩的。但是他是先给我玩，玩了之后要我去传授出去。
要去教。
但是我现在还没有找到我要用什么方式去把我接受到这个美的讯息把它传递出去。
He's saying while his work is done, there's a song, a voice tell him that he should do something with that, to offer it or to give to people, distribute.So he's also thinking how to relate to Krishna and to offer and to give people. He he's not sure yet which way he can do this. Now they are looking for his work.
show.
Yeah, you have to have faith.
要有信心。
嗯，是很重要一点。
信心是没有问题，是。
嗯。他现在不晓得怎么去执行那个声音。做怪一点嘛。
What benefit does he want to get?
你希望从这里面获得什么益处？如果这么去做的话，
不是益处，是应该是说我要怎么把这一件事让更多人可以感受到我那个当下的那种开心。
Oh. Wants more people to know what?
To know the moment when he had this is the joy of the moment he has this inspiration or this work.
要跟人家分享。
Want to share. 嗯？
那你现在是？你要找哪一个？我这里是有拍了几个。还是我拿给他看？你要拿你的右边。
小心那个杯子哈。
这是台北阿维塔，我们有去度过他的工作室，改天想要去那里接探，这是阿维塔啦。
嗯。
好啊，这是就是他的一些作品，这是很大哦。
嗯，
呀。呀，这是花，这是花。
嗯。
他种了一个那个花，然后他。
建筑还没制作的话。
No， 他。
他做的。
对啊，我们去，我跟阿维塔那个是。然后我们准备要去那里 kill
他。他这个是素描还是用什么画？
不是素描，
我们这样我看不太清楚。
你来
。啊，是雕刻吗？
一边底下回来。
这是雕刻吗？
不是、
哦，
这不是雕刻，
这是
一个一个介绍。
毛笔画的。
哦。
一个介绍。
Chinese this a pen, calligraphy pen。
然后
毛笔。
对。
这是这是我最近的作品啊。应该说，这是铅笔素的。
哦，
拿
一根，不是有两个吗？
我远看好像，
我用那个
像水饺，
我用那个柚子
看不清楚。
花了，
对，远远我这
个
距离。
那
个
是花，那可能就是他要跟 Krishna 连接上，然后去荣耀 Krishna， 不是荣耀，要荣耀神。哦，那个比较像那个。
这个就是柚子做出来的。
柚子英文怎么？Maharaj。
柚子 ，pomelo。
嗯。
柚
子。嗯。
我是把肉掏出来，再把皮翻过来。
哦。
所以它有一些难度。
对，是真的柚子。
是
的
那能放多久？还是你在涂上透明漆？
很多人会说能。
这个是很多人问的问题。那全世界我第一个做，我也不知道可以放多久。
哦，因为如果你给它晒干，然后再涂透明漆。
不用，我现在研究到它自然的方式不会。
OK。
你拿给 Maharaj 看吧，你拿给他画。然后呢，现在可能
漂亮，
对，
没有，你免想象这样，那都自然会成型。
你来，
我只是在想说要怎么样把那个。
可是我，如果你展出，你在文化中心还是哪里展，有人要买你就卖。
没有人要把我带去欧洲了。
已经现在有人跟你预约了，
有在
要带去欧洲，哦，
因为在台湾没有用，因为台湾人比较，就是比较迟钝啊，你要从外面展回来的那个效果会比较，
从国外展回来，
要去泡泡盐水比较有价值，
就是，这是台湾的环境形成的，
对，马拉奇可以荣耀不是很，可以
荣耀菩萨呢？
哇啊啊啊啊！这 这些嘞，这些要
什么东西？电子下午是不是还要坐在这里？
哦，对哦，对哦。